This is the story of the three little pigs. High up in the mountains, where the winters are icy cold and the summers are just perfect, there once lived a mother pig and her three nearly grown sons, Max, Mo, and Michael John. One night, Mrs. Pig prepared a special dinner for her sons and sounded the gong that called them all to the table. As usual, Max appeared first, sniffing the delicious aroma coming from the stove.
Oh, Mother, what a fine smell. I'll bet it's corn and dandelion slop stew, my all-time favorite dish. Are you sure there's enough? I've only had 4 full meals and 6 snacks today, and I'm still starving. In fact, I think I'll just grab a small taste
Stay
before...
Stay out of that stew pot, Max!
Hey!
Show some self-control, Max. No one else is here yet, and besides, you eat far too much, even for a growing pig. But here comes Mo now.
Good evening, Mother. Max, is it dinner time already? I was having the most marvelous daydream when I heard the gong. I dreamed of becoming king of the whole land, and the first thing I did was to proclaim that no one could ever again eat pork chops, bacon, or ham. The second thing I did was to make sure that pigs were never called dirty or greedy again. And then I proposed
That's very nice, dear. But it's time to eat now. So please, wash your hooves and come to the table. I wonder where Michael John is.
Right here, Mom. Sorry I'm late, but I was way up on the hill working on the vegetable garden, and I had to put in the new radish plants before nightfall.
We know. You're always somewhere doing something, but it's time to eat. I'm still hungry. My stomach hurts. A little consideration would sure be nice around
here. Enough, Max. Michael John, wash up and come to dinner.
Mrs. Pig and her three nearly grown sons dined lavishly on corn and dandelion slop stew, squash tomato pudding, and banana peel pie. When even Max had eaten his fill, and not a scrap was left on the table, Mrs. Pig looked lovingly at her sons.
Boys, I've been doing some thinking about your future. And I want you to listen carefully to what I have to say. You're all good sons, and I love you very much. But all young pigs must someday become good husbands and fathers. And time has come for you to become grown-up pigs. You need to be out living on your own, building your own houses, providing your own meals.
I'll starve to death, Mother. You know I will. I'm a terrible cook, and I'll surely fade away into nothingness.
If I have to do all that cooking and cleaning, there'll be no time left to think about the world and how to make it a better place for pigs to live in for generations to come.
I don't like
this. What is this?
Our own cooking and cleaning.
Oh, my gosh. What
a
shock.
Build a house. Can you believe it?
Oh, no.
Wait a minute. Perhaps it is time for us to become independent, Mother. But I'd still rather live here with you, Max, and Mo. It's never lonely when we're together.
Listen, boys. I'll miss being together all the time, too. But we'll visit often and have at least one meal a week at this very table. Imagine, we'll have so much to tell each other.
And so, the very next day, the three pigs set out to find building lots for their new homes. Max, as you might guess, chose to build his house in a small field where food would always be close at hand. Midway between the vegetable garden and the fruit grove. Mo picked a spot near a large lake so he could watch the sun setting and the rising moon while he dreamed about the changing world. And Michael John selected a grassy hilltop where he would be able to see anything and everything and always know what was going on. Max was the first one to start building his house.
Oh, look at all that straw scattered about this field. If I build my house out of straw, I'll have everything I need right here. And the very best part is that my house will be finished in no time. By nightfall, it'll be stocked with all of my favorite foods.
And that's exactly what he did. Meanwhile, near the lake, Mo noticed that there were hundreds of tree branches scattered about. Branches that had probably fallen during the harsh winter storms.
These branches would make fine building material for my house. Wood is light in weight and easy to work with. I can even build a tall tower on it and pretend that it's a castle. And the best part is that my house will be finished by midnight. Then I'll be able to sit up and dream.
And that's exactly what he did. Michael John, on the other hand, didn't care how long it would take to build his house. What he wanted was to build a strong house, one that would last for a very long time.
I'll build a brick house. It won't be easy to make all the bricks I need and then haul them up this hill. But when it's finally done, no house in the mountains will be stronger than mine.
And that's exactly what he did. For some time, the pigs lived comfortably in their new homes, visiting their mother each week to share a big meal and some good conversation. But soon, the days began to grow shorter as the winter approached and the pigs had to keep their fireplaces burning in order to stay warm. One particularly stormy day, a lean and hungry wolf wandered into the area, looking for a big meat dinner. Off in the distance, the wolf suddenly noticed smoke spiraling out of a chimney and followed the trail to a small straw house in the center of a field.
A nice little straw house. I wonder what lives within these walls. Perhaps my dinner is lurking there.
The wolf crept silently up to the straw house and peeked through a crack in the shutters. When he saw Max, he licked his lips with pleasure.
Oh, what wonderful luck! Thick, juicy pork chops for dinner. I can almost taste them. But first, I need to get inside. Hello? Is there anyone within these cozy straw walls kind enough to share some food with a cold, hungry traveler? I would be forever grateful for a warm cup of soup and a friendly fireside talk.
Max had been taught to be careful of strangers, so before unlocking the door, he peeked through the peephole and saw the mean-looking wolf standing there, waiting to come in.
You can't fool me, you nasty old wolf. My door is double locked. You won't get me no matter how hard you try. That's what you think, you silly pig. Straw houses are no protection at all. With a huff and a puff, I'll blow your house in. Then I'll have pork chops for dinner.
And that's just what the wolf started to do. With a big huff and an even bigger puff, the wolf blew the tiny straw house to bits. But as luck would have it, the loosened front door fell outward, banging the wolf on the head. And giving Max just enough time to escape, Max ran for his life all the way to Mo's wooden house by the lake.
Mo! There's a wolf who wants to make me his dinner! Help! Open up! Let me in! Hurry!
Quick! Get in, Max! He's right behind you, but we'll be safe here.
Look at that! Two delicious-looking pigs instead of one. Think of it! Pork chops for dinner? Bacon and eggs for breakfast. Fantastic! Mwah! Listen, fellows. I think we got off on the wrong foot. I'm really not at all like the other wolves you've known. In fact, I lost my taste for pork a long while ago. I much prefer a vegetarian diet. Why not let me in for a visit? I'll show you how to make spinach slosh sundaes and turnip tarts. I'm an excellent cook, you know.
Wolf, we'd be pretty dumb to fall for a line like that. We'd never let you in, so you better get out of here or else.
But that's what? I've had enough of you. You don't have to let me in. I can get in any time I wish. Houses made of wooden branches won't keep you safe from the likes of me. I'll huff, I'll puff, and I'll blow your little house down, and then roast pork chops for dinner and sizzling bacon for breakfast.
So the wolf huffed and puffed and huffed and puffed, and the little house broke into thousands of branches, no bigger than matchsticks. All of a sudden, Max and Mo were looking into the hungry, snapping jaws of the wolf. But just as the wolf approached, his foot came down hard on a sharp, thorny branch. Max and Mo
had just enough time to run for their lives. The two pigs ran up the hillside to Michael John's little brick house, yelling all the way.
Help! Michael John! Help! Open the door! Let us in! There's a wolf!
Yeah.
He wants to eat us for dinner!
Right now!
Hurry! Hurry! I can see him right behind you! We'll be safe here. My house is strong.
So you say. We thought our houses were strong, too.
That's
but
right.
The wolf blew them to pieces.
Little tiny bits.
Shh, shh, shh. Listen, he's here. How lucky can a wolf be? Three of them. Imagine it. Roast pork chops for dinner. Sizzling bacon for breakfast. Baked ham with pineapple and molasses for lunch. Piggies. Believe me, you're wasting your time. Be reasonable. You'll never get away from a big, mean, nasty wolf like me. Give up now, and I'll roast you and sizzle you and bake you gently. You won't feel a thing, I promise. Come on now, get it over with. I'm very hungry. Let me in.
You'll never get in, you creepy wolf. The door is bolted, the shutters are sealed, and we're safe within these brick walls. You won't be having us for dinner, or for breakfast, or lunch. Not now, not ever.
I won't. We'll see about that. Your silly little brick house is no protection against a strong, ferocious wolf like me. While I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in just like the other two. Then I'll feast like a king.
Go ahead and try. But I assure you, you won't get anywhere. My brothers and I will be warming ourselves by the fire, making cauliflower soup for dinner. Do as you please, wolf, but at least be quiet about it.
And so the wolf huffed and puffed and huffed and puffed again. But nothing happened. So we tried again and again, faster and faster and harder, but not one brick moved. Desperate, he tried one last thing. He huffed his hardest huff and puffed his strongest puff until he realized that he couldn't blow the little house in.
Haven't you given up yet, wolf?
Quit! I'll never quit! It may be true that I can't blow your little brick house in, but I'll get you yet. I'll just sit out here and wait. You'll have to come out sometime, and when you do, I'll be waiting.
Make yourself comfortable, wolf. My little house is well stocked. We have no need to come out for a long, long time.
So the wolf waited, and waited while the sun set and the moon rose, and then the moon set and the sun rose again, until the wolf was completely out of patience. Then, suddenly, he noticed the chimney and knew exactly what to do.
I'm through waiting, pigs! Either you come out now, or I'll climb on the roof and come down through the chimney.
Do as you please, wolf.
So, the wolf climbed onto the roof. But as the wolf came down through the chimney, tail first, Michael John opened the cover of the soup pot. The wolf's long tail dipped into the boiling cauliflower broth. The pain sent the wolf scurrying back up the chimney and screaming out into the night, and he was never heard from again. And that's why, even to this day, all smart pigs always build their houses out of bricks.